Alan Morgan and his beautiful, this is actually a K-Code Fastback that he took from a shell and completely restored, mildly resto-modded. It does have the correct K-Code motor in it. It has Baer brakes on it now, so it features kind of the larger 10 spokes on it. What size are those? 17s? Yeah. And he put those on there to keep an original style look, but he's running the Baer brakes, so you've got to clear, obviously, the large rotor and that large caliper. You have to run a bigger wheel-tire combo. And the paint on it is absolutely spectacular. So I'm going to turn it over to Alan. The car is really, really nice. Even the rear bumpers are Frenched in. And but the paint work is spectacular. This is copper. This is the what color is the copper called? It is. Oh, it is Emberglo. Yeah, that's a 1 year only, right?
Yep.
And it was a T-bird color at that, right? Wasn't it?
It started on the Mustang, the 65s.
Oh, okay.
I think they have a bronze color that's very similar. I don't know if you want to know, the body and paintwork was done by Don Becker, Tempe. It's really, really good.
The bright work, everything, and he was mentioning, I guess, he must be a famous body man painter in Tempe, but as you know, how many cars have we shown on Mustang Connection? Literally hundreds, and this car, the fit and finish is spectacular. So enough about me talking, I'm going to turn it over to Alan now. So
basically, when I started looking at cars, I decided to do the 65 K-Code Fastback just because everybody else was doing the big block engines. And the K-Code engine is really the first time that Ford tried to put out a really high performance engine to compete with other cars similar to it. And I just wanted to go with something, first of all, it was rare. Secondly, it was not a big block. And it was just more interesting to me than anything else. So what I did is I made a plan on the type of car that I wanted. I hunted for a K-Code for quite a while. I found one that I could afford, which was basically a shell.
Let me pan over here and I'll show you. He's been featured in Mustang Monthly, just to give you an idea. But there's a shot of what he started with right there. An old race car, essentially, a shell. So, and when was that? How long ago did you pick the car up?
It was about 7 years ago.
Wow, so.
So it's been a long time.
But still recent. I mean, this is in the 2000s. Yeah. It wasn't like this was in the 90s.
Yeah, it's only been done for about 3-4 years. So that kind of gives you an idea of what actually came in these cars and how rare they are.
Boy, and I'll tell you, finding a K-Code motor now is almost, they're just crazy expensive. You want to talk about K-Code motors a little bit? It is, it's a solid lifter. It's a 4-bolt main, and they were supposedly had the better, higher nickel content, right? They were Mexican block cast in Mexico.
Yeah, mainly the difference in the 289 engine are the heads. The heads had screw-in studs for the lifters. And the other difference is, if you look on here, this is a mechanical distributor. There's no vacuum advance. They use a larger harmonic balancer down below to take up the extra 2,000 RPM. It has the thicker rod caps, thicker rod bearings.
Even a special pulley, so
right.
The alternator doesn't work
as well.
Everything
on the engine was built to take up an additional 2,000 RPMs.
And of course, the K-Code motor was the basis for all of the Shelby GT350 cars.
Yes.
Essentially, this car, in this configuration, would have been what Shelby took.
Yes.
And modified. It's the same
exactly.
car.
Yes.
And these all the K-Codes mandated a 9-inch factory rear end as well.
Right, and they also had a different transmission. It's a 4-speed, but it's a close ratio 4-speed. So it's a little different. It shifts better through every RPM than the others.
And you put it back to, again, it's got the 4-speed back in it.
Yep.
It's got the 9-inch back in it, which I'm sure that was probably still there if it was raced.
Yeah, I put back everything that I knew the car would have from the
It's a beautiful deluxe pony interior, two-tone.
Parchment and Emberglo.
It's beautiful. And the dash is not cut. He's got an original style AM radio in it. He's got the Rally-Pac in it. A beautiful deluxe steering wheel.
cool little shift knob on it. And of course, all the early cars, 65, 66, are all fold down sport deck rear seats. But the car is just stunning. You know, I use a lot of adjectives because I filmed so many incredible Mustangs. This is right up there. I mean, it's, you know, the color of the paint, just the fit and finish and everything.
It's just, it's great that you understand what the car is.
Now, let me ask you this. Why'd you decide to sell now? What's the impetus to just time or just...
I retired in January.
I gotcha.
And I bought horses.
They're expensive.
So my wife is into performance horses, so I need a barn.
I gotcha.
And this looks a lot like
this
a barn.
Is what a barn's going to look like right here.
Just this like
is,
this.
Yes. Well, I'm sure this is barn money here for sure, so...
Well, if not, I'll take it home and yeah. not a big deal.
Well, it's a beautiful car, just a great Mustang, and really a nice treat to see that it's a K-Code that's been put back with a few custom touches, but not much, you know, just a couple little custom touches here and there, and just really tastefully done. Beautiful car.
Yeah, I did the copper thing for three reasons. One, Arizona's the copper state. It kind of goes with the color of the car, and at one point, I worked for a copper mine.
So it, oh, really?
It
wow.
fits three different
things. Again, thanks, Alan. Really appreciate it.
Sure.
I don't want to get you too far out in the aisle, Alan. That's all. Sounds great. You know what? I love the solid liquid on these. It sounds so cool.